Good morning, student, and welcome to online tutorial. Myself Sachin Patil, and I am your computer teacher. From today onwards, we are going to learn by online process. So, my dear student, let us start our unit first, chapter first, History of Computers. In this chapter, we are going to learn about the computer devices and the generation of computers and characteristics of computers. So first we start the first point, early computer devices. Let us learn about some of the early computing machines. Which are these? The first early computing device is Abacus. Abacus was the first calculating device. Simple calculation like addition, subtraction could be easily performed using Abacus. Means, what is it means? Abacus was the first calculating device. First calculating device means it is the first calculator or a computer device. What this device is do? That device is do the simple calculation like addition and subtraction. Then after, the next computer device is Napier's bone. Napier's bone. What this Napier's bone is do? In 1616, Sir John Napier invented a calculating device which was made up of wooden rods. This device can do simple addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and finding the square root. Napier's bone. It is the second computer device. This device is invented by Sir John Napier. It is the mathematician, great mathematician. He invented the computing device that is Napier's bone, and the device is can be performed addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and finding the square root. The next computing device is Pascaline. What is Pascaline? See, Pascaline, in 1642, Blaise Pascal invented a calculating machine. Blaise Pascal, it is the name of a great scientist who invented this calculating device, and that device is given the name Pascaline. It consists of rectangular box. This device is made up of rectangular box with eight movable wheels. Means there is a eight wheels which are mounted on this rectangular box. And that wheels are move. Wheels which could calculate up to eight figures. This device can do the calculation up to eight figures. This much of calculation is done by this computing device. The next computing device is Leibniz calculator. Leibniz calculator. See, Gottfried Wilhelm von Leibniz, a German mathematician, designed a mechanical calculating device called Stepp-Rechner in 1671. The German mathematician who was designed the mechanical calculating device, and that device name is given by a Stepp-Rechner, and this device can able to do addition, subtraction, multiplication, division of the numbers. Now the next computing device is the Jacquard loom. The Jacquard loom, it is also a calculating device, and that device is used for making the fabric or weaving a yarn or thread. That apparatus, loom means it is an apparatus for making the fabric by weaving yarn or thread. What these devices do? It is invented by Joseph Marie Jacquard. This machine uses punch card. Punch card means just like a ATM card, that kind of cards they are using to operate the machine. These punch cards control the weaving of the clothes. This device is used for weaving the clothes, and there is a small punch card they can use to operate this machine. The next computing device is Harvard Mark I. Now, Harvard Aiken, a professor, designed an electromechanical calculator in 1945. He was the professor. He designed an electromechanical calculator in 1945. It is also known as ASCC. ASCC is stand for Atomic Sequence Controller Calculator. Automatic Sequence Control Calculator. This kind of device is used for the sequential calculation. For the sequential calculation is are done in this device. The next calculating device is ENIAC. What is ENIAC? ENIAC stand for Electronic Numeric Integrated and Computer. E for electronic, N for numeric, I for integrated, and C for computer. ENIAC. It was the first general purpose electronic computer. This ENIAC device is called as the first general purpose electronic computer, and this device is invented by J. Prosper Eckert and John Maudslay. Who is invented ENIAC? ENIAC is invented J. Prosper Eckert and John Maudslay. It solve what this ENIAC is do? This ENIAC is solve numeric problems, means a simple calculation. Now, the ENIAC used about 1800 square feet. How much area is covered? Means it is a very huge size of device. This device is used about 1800 square feet area. In 1800 square feet area, this device is mounted. And this device is used 17,468 vacuum tubes, and the weight of this device is about 50 tons. So this ENIAC is a very big device, and this device is used vacuum tubes. So this is the computing device. Now the next computing device is ENIAC first. It stands for Universal Automatic Computer. U for universal, A for automatic computer. Universal Automatic Computer was also designed by J. Prosper Eckert and John Maudslay. This device is also developed or designed by J. Prosper Eckert and John Maudslay. It was the first commercial electronic computer. The ENIAC was the first commercial electronic computer. It handles both numbers and textual data very well. Means this ENIAC computing device handle or can perform numeric operations and also a textual operations. Means both the operations can done by ENIAC 1. The next computing device is difference engine. Difference engine. In the 19th century, Charles Babbage invented the first mechanical computer. Is called difference engine. Charles Babbage invented. The first mechanical computer is called difference engine. Means who is invented? Charles Babbage invented the first mechanical computer, and that mechanical computer is called as a difference engine. It was designed to calculate polynomial functions. This computing device is to calculate polynomial functions. Polynomial functions means what? There is a series of calculation, just like x raised to 2 plus y raised to 3, just type of examples they can solve. So this is called as a difference engine. Now the next one is analytical engine. Analytical engine was invented in 1833 by Charles Babbage, and given the name analytical engine. With this engine could generate table. This analytical engine can able to generate the table. It was the first general purpose computer and had the basic concept of input, output and memory devices that are found in modern computer. Now you know, in today's computer, both the input, output and memory devices we can found. So the same way, that devices is also found in analytical engine. So that is why this computing device is called as a first general purpose computer. So in this computing device, the numeric operations as well as textual operations and storage operations can perform in this analytical engine. That's why it is called as a general purpose computer. So these are the some computing devices that we had learned today. I hope you had enjoyed this session. Now the next point we will learn on the next session. Thank you.